More than 110,000 people are taking part in rescue operations in Japan after its worst storm in decades struck over the weekend. Typhoon Hagibis ripped across central and northern Japan, claiming at least 31 lives.
This is the town of Chikuma in the Japanese Alps, much of it now enveloped by brown, dirty floodwater. On Saturday night, the levees burst. All day, the military has been racing to pluck those stranded from roofs and balconies. It is a story that has been repeated over and over. This afternoon, we made it to Kawagoe, an hour north of Tokyo. Here, too, the rivers have burst their banks.
This behind me is an old people's home where 220 people were stranded last night when the floodwaters came in here. You can see they're still taking people out 18 hours later. What's truly remarkable about this typhoon is its scale. There are floods and rescues like this going on in at least 8 different prefectures right across the main island of Japan.
People we talk to are shocked and numb.
I have lived here 32 years. It is the first time I have seen anything like this. I was shaking with fear last night.
Japan is just starting to count the economic cost of this single storm. Outside Nagano City, a line of shiny bullet trains swamped by the floodwaters. Each one of these trains costs $29 million.